Spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
And welcome to this third Sunday of Easter, everyone. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
You have made known to me the paths of life.
You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus. Of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father and poured him forth, as you see and hear. The word of the Lord. Reverence during the time of your sojourning. realizing that you were ransomed from your futile conduct, handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless, unblemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Found gathered together the 11
and those with them who were saying, "The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There are two paths to walk in life, and they're completely opposite. One path is a road of fear, hopelessness, and despair. The other road is one of new life, love, and hope. And that's what today's gospel is about. It's about these two roads. Look at the two disciples in today's gospel. These two disciples are walking away from Jerusalem. They are walking towards Emmaus. Jerusalem is evocative of God's rescue operation for the whole world. Emmaus is a Roman garrison town. It's evocative of worldly power. By walking away from Jerusalem, these two disciples are signaling the fact that they do not understand what the death and resurrection of Jesus is all about. So guess what, everyone? These two disciples are seeking security in something other than God. Isn't that the temptation that we face every day? It's easy to forget what Jesus did in his death and resurrection. So what do? We tend to seek security in something other than God. You know, worldly power, success, material things. I can go on and on and on. Now, everything in itself is good. I know you're tired of me hearing me say this. But like I've said over and over again, everything in this world in itself is good. That means material things, pleasure, power. These are all good things. We need these things to live. I personally like having AC in the summertime. I love my Jeep. I like good food. Who does not like sitting around eating hot boiled crawfish on a spring afternoon? But I cannot find security in these things. They're fleeting. They come and they go. If I rely on contingent things to make me feel safe, secure, and happy, guess what? I'm going to be disappointed. And not only will I be disappointed, but I will eventually become hopeless and depressed. Is that any way to live? I don't think so. Here's the good news, everyone. Despite the fact that if we are walking in the wrong direction, God's not going to sit there and watch us self-destruct. No, what God does is he comes to us and he meets us where we are. And you see it in today's gospel. Jesus himself drew near to these two disciples and he walked with them. That's what God does. It's not our quest for God. It's God's quest for us. Jesus meets us in our disappointments, in our despair, in our hopelessness. You know what he says to each one of us? There's a way out. There's a way out. And that way out is to see and believe in God's rescue operation. Then it is to enter into that rescue operation. It's Jesus who points us to the fact that God created the world. Therefore, everything in this world is good. Yes, evil and diseases and death have more of this world, but guess what, everyone? Jesus dealt with these things in his death and resurrection. A new creation has begun. The original Easter Sunday was the beginning of a new creation. Now is the time to get on board. And that's the road back to Jerusalem. A road where we walk the path of life, hope, and love. So how do we get back on that road to Jerusalem? We get back on it, everyone, by participating in the Eucharist. The Eucharist sums up the new creation. You know why? Because that bread and that wine is taken up by God and is transfigured into a new creation. That's where God becomes all in all. So wherever you are in your life, everyone, stop and listen to Jesus. And if you do, your hearts will burn for more. And where do we find that more? In the Eucharist. It's where your eyes will be opened to a whole new world. One where you will find safety, you will find security, and you will find hope. It's in the Eucharist where God takes us up. He transforms us. He transfigures us. And we become a new creation. So that begs the question, which road are you going to walk? The road of despair, hopelessness, and fear? Or are you going to go back to Jerusalem? The road of new life, hope, and love.
Now let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now let us bring our petitions to God our Father.
For the church throughout the world, made Jesus our head, grant us reconciliation and unity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For war-torn nations, that they may there be peace in every place experiencing violence and war, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those saddened by loss and discouragement, may the promises of the risen Lord lift them from their despair. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in this community who struggle with their faith, may God's word open their hearts and nourish them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our brothers and sisters in Christ who have died, may they rejoice in the presence of our Heavenly Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, our nation, and our state leaders, that they may have the wisdom to lead us forward out of this pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those suffering from the COVID-19, that they may be strengthened by the peace of our Lord and be healed of their illness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those for whom our mass, Sunday Masses are being offered as listed in our bulletin, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, you are in our midst of our struggles and our disappointments and our fears. Therefore, we lift up all these petitions to you, and we ask you to answer them according to your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Right, gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who
trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Telling of our woes.
Let us pray. Look kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And I'm sure Deacon Dennis does not mind me speaking on his behalf, but we are looking so forward to celebrating what we're going to celebrate. Our first Mass back together again. We're this close, everyone. This close. I want to thank Brother Ken, Mr. Cleveland on flute, and Mrs. Cleveland, Kitty, as our cantor. Beautiful music, guys. Thank you. And of course, my own personal cameraman, Simon. So thank you, Simon. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.